Imagine a distant world, a cosmic underdog lurking in the shadows of the vast and mysterious expanse of space. It's a plucky little planet that dances to its own rhythm, defying the rules and expectations of the solar system. With its icy surface and enigmatic demeanor, it's a celestial enigma that has long captivated the curious minds of astronomers and space enthusiasts alike. Its story is one of intrigue, controversy, and wonder, shrouded in the veil of cosmic mystery. You probably already know what I'm talking about, so prepare to unveil the secrets of this captivating world, which, with the most recent study, suggests that living organisms can be beneath its surface. Let's lift the veil and discover the fascinating world of Pluto. Welcome to Adventures in Space. Pluto, the most distant celestial object of our solar system, located approximately 40 astronomical units away from the Sun. Its mystery starts with a highly elliptical orbit that takes it around the Sun in an inclined and elongated path, taking approximately 248 Earth years to complete a single orbit. You have to understand that humans have not yet completely observed the full swing of Pluto's orbit, since its discovery was made not even 100 years ago. The very first suggestion that Pluto existed was made in 1905 by an American astronomer, Percival Lowell, when he smashed that like button and subscribed to Adventures in Space. You should probably do that too, but really, Percival observed strange deviations in the orbits of Neptune and Uranus. Lowell thought there must be another object whose gravity is tugging on these ice giants, causing discrepancies in their orbits. It was not until 1930 when another astronomer, Clyde Tombaugh, finally found Pluto based on deceased Lowell's predictions. To his honor, a distinct feature on Pluto's surface with a large heart-shaped region will forever be known unofficially as Tombaugh Regio. This strange world is located in the Kuiper Belt, a zone beyond the orbit of Neptune, brimming with hundreds of thousands of rocky ice bodies, each larger than 62 miles across, as well as 1 trillion or more comets. Pluto is a fascinating blend of rock and ice, just like a cosmic ice king of our solar system. Its surface is covered in frozen nitrogen, methane, and carbon monoxide, which give it a unique and colorful appearance. But here's the cool part. When Pluto is farthest from the Sun, its thin atmosphere, made mostly of nitrogen with hints of methane and carbon monoxide, actually freezes and falls back onto the surface, creating a frosty layer that's out of this world stunning. It's like Pluto is putting on its winter coat during the chillest part of its orbit. And it is truly chilly up there in the outer reaches of our solar system. That's why Pluto's surface temperature can drop to around negative 375 to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Pluto is remaining to this day a highly sensitive subject for a discussion to many people, and mainly because in 2006, Pluto was reclassified as a dwarf planet by the International Astronomical Union. And from that time, our solar system have only 8 planets within it. The negotiations were very hard, but was primarily based on facts like planets' orbits, sizes, and general astronomy classifications. In addition to a not inherent Pluto's orbit, its size is also minuscule. With a diameter of just about 1400 miles, Pluto is smaller than our moon. You can easily fit this dwarf planet on Australian continent, or in perspective, it is roughly half the size of the United States. We as humans will never stop being curious of what's up there and beyond, and a monumental role in our understanding of the outer solar system was NASA's little spacecraft called the New Horizons. Launched also in 2006, it embarked on a 9-year journey across 3 billion miles of space to conduct a historic flyby of Pluto. In 2015, the New Horizons probe became the first spacecraft to visit the dwarf planet, providing an unprecedented high-resolution images of Pluto, revealing the complexity and diversity of this fascinating world. It also made groundbreaking discoveries about Pluto's moons, revealing their unique properties and interactions. Yes, you've heard me right. Pluto has 5 moons, with 2 of them only being discovered in 2015 by the New Horizons, named Hydra and Nix. With other 3 moons named Charon, Kerberos, and Styx, Pluto is defying its own world to a whole new system. Only in 1978, astronomers discovered that Charon is the largest moon, nearly half the dwarf planet's own size. Because Charon and Pluto are so similar in size, they both orbit a point in space that lies between them, similar to the orbits of binary star systems. And for that reason, scientists sometimes refer to Pluto and Charon as the double dwarf planet, or binary system. But here's where you will be truly amazed. Pluto and Charon are just 12,200 miles apart, less than the distance by flight between London and Sydney. Imagine these two celestial objects being habitable for a moment, and you could travel between them like you traveling to a different continent here on Earth. Charon's orbit around Pluto takes 6.4 Earth days, and one Pluto rotation, a Pluto day, also takes 6.4 Earth days. This is because Charon hovers over the same spot on Pluto's surface, and the same side of Charon always faces Pluto, a phenomenon known as tidal locking. Looking back to a New Horizons historic flyby of Pluto in 2015, it took some serious cosmic patience to get all the precious data back to Earth. Because of such vast distance, the data could be transmitted at the rate of just 1 to 4 kilobits per second, plus a whopping 4.5-hour delay for the speed of light. But after 15 months, we now can easily gaze through astounding high-resolution pictures of this precious world. According to an accepted model, scientists have estimated that Pluto probably consists of a mixture of 70% rock and 30% water ice. So underneath its mesmerizing surface that covered with craters and mountains similar to the Rockies here on Earth, Pluto's mantle may have a layer with a liquid water closer to its rocky core, which is estimated to be 1,100 miles thick. In the center left of Tombaugh Regio is a very smooth region unofficially known by the New Horizons team as Sputnik Planitia. This region of Pluto's surface lacks craters caused by meteorite impact, suggesting that the area is, on geologic timescale, very young, no more than 100 million years old. It's possible that this region is still being shaped and changed by geologic processes. Scientists found that the zone of Sputnik Planitia redirected Pluto's orientation due to the amount of ice in the area, which was so heavy that it affected Pluto overall. New Horizons estimated that the ice is roughly 6 miles thick, and the best explanation for the evidence of ice layer movements in this area can be a subsurface ocean. It is definitely toxic for humans, as it will contain mostly dissolved ammonia. But even with this possibility of liquid water beneath Pluto's surface and enough energy, some scientists think Pluto could even harbor life. As we continue to explore the mysteries of our vast universe, Pluto serves as a reminder of the endless wonders that awaits us in space. Its story of intrigue, controversy, and wonder continues to unfold, and we eagerly await future missions and discoveries that will further unravel the secrets of this cosmic enigma. And if you want to discover for yourself new, potentially habitable worlds, then you absolutely must watch this video up here, and you will see that some worlds are very similar to our baby Pluto. This was Georgie with Adventures in Space, and I will see you at the next one.